Hi everybody, today is February 6, 2013. This is the Global Times, China, so you can understand it's from their point of view. Japan sends dubious signals of war. Japan on Tuesday lodged a protest against China, claiming Chinese military frigates locked their fire control radar on a Japanese vessel as well as a helicopter. Details of the situation remain unclear. The Japanese Defense Ministry reportedly said that the Japanese vessel sounded a combat alert after being locked onto, and the situation reached quite a dangerous point. It prompted Japanese media to criticize China's offensive and provocation act on the high seas. China, it says, if you want to believe this, is not skilled when it comes to publicity efforts. Thus far, has never taken the initiative to publicizing information on Sino-Japanese disputes. The first commentaries on the Sino-Japanese conflict have always come from the Japanese side. But if Japan was a reasonable nation, the Diu Island dispute wouldn't have become as tense as it is now, so they're putting all the blame on Japan. Japan bought these islands, flat out. And China started doing their provocation, sending warships, fighter planes, etc. Goes on to say, now we only have Japan's one-sided arguments over the radar incident. Since Japan often seizes opportunities to exaggerate these kinds of incidents to sway public opinion, the legitimacy of Japan's argument has come under question. It was also posted in the Korean newspapers, more specific North Korea. No matter how skilled Japan is making use of public opinion, it's Japan itself that is driving the Diu dispute in the direction of a possible military clash. Japan has conducted several military exercises aimed to safeguarding Diu, and it's Japan's fighter jets that first appeared in the air above the disputed island to disperse Chinese civilian aircraft. They were not. They were fighter jets from China. Like I said, this is Global Times China. I have another article that I'll read to you from the Japanese point of view. It was also Japan that first indicated that it might use tracer bullets against Chinese aircraft and Japan's fighter jets that were frequently scrambled to deal with Chinese aircraft that allegedly entered into its air defense identification zone. Because of Japan, mutual military trust in the East China Sea has been destroyed. The news disclosed by Japan on Tuesday hasn't stirred up Chinese society. Many have mentally prepared themselves for the first shots between China and Japan, but fewer and fewer people still hold out hope for a peaceful solution to the escalating dispute. Japan sent diplomats to China trying to get this settled, but China just don't want to bend. There's just too much water under the bridge. Chinese people thought in the past war was unlikely, but now we often hear extreme pledges from Japan, like protecting Diu at any cost and negotiations are unacceptable, viva media and the internet. And we are also well informed of the Japanese self-defense forces full preparations for war. China's done the same thing. They told their people to prepare for war. They've been stockpiling food, metals, you name it, for almost 2 years preparing for war. There's money in war. Plus they have a surplus of a population they probably want to get rid of. The information flow between China and Japan is increasingly narrowing the room for peaceful negotiation. Japan's attempt to highlight this radar incident only sound an alert between the Chinese and Japanese public, telling them that war is around the corner. China did the same thing, and I posted that article. If the Abe administration's real intention is to implant the idea of an immediate war in the minds of the public, China must also send the same message to the Chinese public. If this is not the case, Japan should try to dispel the Chinese public doubts and remove the harmful side effects of this action. So it starts out saying that China is not skilled when it comes to publicity efforts, right? This is all publicity, this whole article. It's all propaganda. Every dot of the line. So here's what the Japanese are saying. Abe calls radar locking incident on high seas regrettable and dangerous. It was a locking device for either rocket or missiles or something. But their systems indicated that they were locked on for an attack. Analysts have questioned whether the Chinese frigates that allegedly aimed weapon targeting radar at a Japanese destroyer and a helicopter last month were being provocated or responding to unannounced threats. Tokyo said yesterday the incidents were extremely regrettable and dangerous, but the defense ministry in Beijing remained silent on Japan's accusations first aired on Tuesday. The latest spat has led to further doubts that the two nations can peacefully resolve their territory dispute in the East China Sea over the Diu Islands. Call this a neck use in Japan, and regardless of Beijing's motives. Yeah, I agree. There's more to it than these stupid islands. China's been stockpiling, and I've done articles on that. They're just using this as an excuse to go to war. Chinese Defense Minister said on Tuesday that a Chinese frigate directed fire control radar at a Japanese destroyer in the East China Sea on January 30th. A similar incident involving a Japanese helicopter occurred on January 19th. Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe said Beijing's move was dangerous and could have led to an unpredictable situation. Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesman said yesterday she was not aware of the specifics of the incident, and the Defense Ministry did not respond to requests for comments. A Shanghai University of Political Science and Law spokesperson said that the Chinese military might have been responding to provocations by Japanese ships. Tokyo said that the Chinese frigate and the Japanese destroyer were about 3 kilometers apart during the January 30th incident. Broadcaster NHK said both incidents occurred on the high seas, some 100 kilometers north of the Diaoyus. Gary Lyon, expert on the People's Liberation Army at the London-based private intelligence firm Exclusive Analysis, said that distance between ships was short for large naval vessels, and sending a warning was a desirable decision by the Chinese captain if the Japanese ship was too close. Another professor from an Academy of Social Sciences said it was possible that Beijing was testing how the Japanese Navy would handle emergencies. The move possibly resulted in a miscalculation of each other's intention, he said. The incident has triggered concern in Japan that the Chinese military is running wild and is not eager to resolve the dispute through peaceful dialogue. I think the Chinese military actually runs the whole Chinese government. This is an escalation of Chinese action and designed to show its coercive power and military capabilities, said Professor Gao Ito, an international relations specialist at Meiji University in Tokyo. And it's not just over the islands. It's to do with overall relations, including the disagreement over the continental shelf territory within the East China Sea and so on. And that's oil. That's all oil. The last war started because of the blockade for fuel to Japan over oil. Oil. Looks like they're running short again. Look at the smog in Beijing. Look at the air pollution they have there in China. It was so bad there one day, they actually had to close the airport because of visibility from smog, air pollution. I mean, it's obvious they don't give a hoot about the environment. This is not fog. This is air pollution from their factories. One good thing about if there is war, let's say there's an EMP blast, it'll shut down all these polluting-making factories around the world. I remember when 9/11 happened, all aircraft were grounded here in the United States. And it was amazing how clear. It was amazing. It was a breath of fresh air because there was no contrails being laid and poisoning us. So can you imagine if all the factories are shut down, how clear the air will be? Hey, you gotta think positive, right? All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.